The U.S. Navy, on December 9th, test-fired the latest version of the Raytheon RGM-109 Tomahawk cruise missile. The USS Chaffee, a DDG-51 destroyer, conducted the first operational test of the Raytheon Tomahawk Block V. The aim of the testing was to support the initial fleet release of the Block V Tomahawk's navigation and communications (NAVCOMS) upgrade, as well as upgrades to the Theater Mission Planning Center (TMPC) system and the Tactical Tomahawk Weapons Control System (TTWCS). Tomahawk Weapons Systems Program Manager Captain John Redd stated, "This is the culmination of years of planning and effort. We're working every day to modernize the Tomahawk missile and to deliver the best warfighting capability to the fleet." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the U.S. Navy's Tomahawk Block V is a major step forward. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Tomahawk is a long-range, all-weather, jet-powered, subsonic cruise missile. It was designed and initially produced in the 1970s by General Dynamics. At least 6 variants and multiple upgraded versions have been introduced since then, including air, sub, and ground-launched variants, and conventional and nuclear-armed ones. Tomahawk uses a liquid-fuel turbojet engine because it enabled greater range than a rocket engine of roughly the same size. A slower speed also makes low-altitude flight more viable, which in turn makes the missile much more difficult to detect by radar. Depending on the variant, the missile has a maximum range of 1,550 miles or 2,500 kilometers. Over the years, the missile has seen many upgrades to keep it relevant. The Tomahawk missile, which debuted in Operation Desert Storm, has been fired more than 2,300 times. The Tomahawk was most recently used by the U.S. Navy against Syrian chemical weapons facilities when 66 were launched in the 2018 missile strikes against Syria. Let's now check what's special about the latest Block V variant. The good news is that the Block 4 variant of Tomahawk can be upgraded to Block 5. This will essentially enable the reuse of existing missiles, which will facilitate faster deployment time. All Block 4 will be converted to become Block 5 Tomahawks, said Captain John Redd, speaking to reporters during the 2020 Service Navy Association Symposium. The upgrades are being done at Raytheon's Tucson, Arizona facility. The existing Tomahawk Block 3 missiles will be retired and demilitarized. The administration requested $320 million for research and development in the fiscal year 2020 budget to move ahead on these upgrades to Tomahawk. As of now, Block 5 will have 2 variants, 5A and 5B. The Block 5A variants will be called Maritime Strike. It will have a new seeker capable of hitting a moving target, so it could be used to target a rival's surface combatants. The target information in the variant could be updated in flight. The warhead will be geared towards destroying enemy warship. Block 5B will feature the JMEWS, or Joint Multi-Effects Warhead System. The new warhead was first announced in 2010 and tested in 2014. It's a 2-stage warhead that combines blast fragmentation and enhanced penetration in one warhead. It will be able to destroy a wide variety of targets, soft targets like parked aircraft, as well as hardened ones like bunkers. During an August 2010 test, The initial stage of the warhead created a hole large enough in a reinforced bunker for the follow-through element to penetrate the concrete target and pass through two witness plates. JMEWS has seen further improvement, the details of which have been withheld. The Tomahawk 5A and 5B variants were highlighted in the administration's new offensive missile strategy. Block 5 will see major upgrades to the missile's communication and navigation systems. This will make it hard for the enemy to jam the missile with electronic countermeasures. This will mean that more missiles will be able to navigate unhindered to the target and hit them. In 2017, Raytheon's Tomahawk program manager told reporters at an event at the missile plant in Tucson, Arizona, that the navigation system upgrades will ensure the missile can strike targets even if GPS is taken down. It's interesting to note that Block 3 added GPS, removing a time-consuming programming system that required 80 hours to plot a missile's course, as well as a loitering capability. Near-peer rivals like Russia and China have anti-satellite weapons that could cripple the GPS system. The ability to work without GPS will make the missile very robust. The missile will see an improved stealth characteristic, though the exact nature of which is classified. Since the missile's external contour will remain the same, it's likely that the missile will see the use of RAM, or radar-absorbing material. Stealth is achieved by designing the asset in such a way that radar signals reflect away in a different direction or get absorbed and don't reach back to the sensor, which is emitting them. RAM will soak up the radar signals. U.S. military has a lot of expertise in RAM, as it's developed stealth fighter like F-22 Raptor, B-2 Spirit, as well as F-35 Joint Strike Fighter. This know-how is likely to come in handy. Even the Block 5 variant will cost around $1 million price range, which is on the low end for missiles. Raytheon's supersonic SM-6, which can reach speeds of Mach 3.5, costs more than four times as much per shot and has less range. The low cost of the Tomahawk will ensure that they'll be acquired in large numbers. Viewers may note that Arleigh Burke class has up to 96 cell VLS, while Ticonderoga class cruiser has up to 122 cell VLS. The U.S. Navy has around 68 Arleigh Burke class destroyers and 22 Ticonderoga class cruisers in active service. This means on any day, the U.S. Navy will have a potent payload of these missiles, which can be fired from long ranges. So, American warships will be able to saturate enemy air defenses with a massive barrage. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.